So let's start working on the back of the head now. One thing I do want to point out again is we've got some filler space here. We can easily go ahead and duplicate and just, I'm going to actually delete the half group over there. Just duplicate and move one of the fur polygon objects over here. Might even shrink it a little bit just so that we don't interrupt the silhouette of our character here. So let's take a look at this. It's looking good. And same deal as before, we're going to go ahead and add some edges here. The only exception is we don't need to apply to the topology of our head mesh here. That's because this is actually hidden in the background. You won't be able to see it. There's no point. That's just extra work that isn't going to be necessary. So let's keep this simple by clipping it directly into the into our skull. And the great thing is with the back of the skull is that it's not going to be deforming that much. Okay, so we can work with far less. I'm going to insert edge loop here. Oops, not that way. Do it in that direction. And let's just increase the size. Might also deselect that middle bit here. And we'll go ahead and round it off like so. Something like that. And of course, the vertices, we can go and merge them together. Great. That one's done. Let's move on to the next one. Just keep in mind how many... Okay, we don't have to touch these. These belong to the top of the head, so let's just be careful not to interrupt that. We can focus on this one here. Like so. And we can adjust the topology. So that hair is looking nice. I'm going to go ahead and create just the edges here. And yes, I probably shouldn't have merged it prior, but that's all right. And what we're doing is we're delineating it ever so slightly. Give us a nice appealing result. So just to add consistency, I'm going to go ahead and split edges. All right, looking great. Looking really nice. So, hair still readable. Looking good overall. Same deal here. Let's go and add just a couple of extra edges here. Like so, and then we can add additional resolution. And over here I might shrink this one, bring it up, this one might bring it down, and the end, we merge the vertex, like that. Check our concept, our character sheet, and it's consistent, looking really good. I just straighten some of these edges here. Just make sure the curve is nice and wavy. It's following that pathway. So that's good. 1, 2, 3. Next one. This one's simple again. I'm going to duplicate those edges. Go to the side view. Merge vertex. Like so. I won't divide top-wise or from that particular angle here. So I'll leave it as it is because I think this poly count is pretty good. It's readable already. We don't need to add any more. Okay. That's the last thing we want to do. We don't want to add too many polygons. Just increases our poly count for very little readability. Same deal here. merge vertex on the edge, add that extra edge, and just round it off, making sure it follows somewhat that little pathway here. Okay. Very easy. Might equalize these edges. I might just adjust those. Okay, just so that we have it's a bit more linear. Otherwise it might cause a little bit of skewing in our textures. Alright, so the solid ones are done. Oh, we've got one more right here. Very simple. Again, create another poly count or edge loop. Shrink that one, rotate, making sure I follow the flow and merge the vertices on the end. Something nice and pointy right there. Might even move it slightly in, and that will do. I'm okay with the hair follicles clipping over each other here, okay, because the readability is still there. That's the important thing. On the face down here, clipping it may make it may be a bit visible to us when we see it front on, so that's why I kind of left it and I haven't duplicated on that side. That's all right. So looking good. All right, that's the top of the head. All right, let's go back into wireframe on shaded. And this is where we can go and just fix up some of these areas here. So that particular fur card is a bit weird, but I think we can adjust it. And what I want to do is lock it onto the ears. So the ear here. Pardon me, not selecting that. And where do I want to put it? I might stick it maybe over here or here. And come to think of it, I'll also hide the top of the hair there. It's making a job a little bit tricky. So put in a layer, call it top temporarily. Same deal with all this other stuff. Get out of there. We need to work. Okay. And how we can approach this particular fur card, we'll have to make a decision. So the creative decision now is to sort of cut it around in this direction. And just to help with the UV maps, I'm going to splice a polygon. Okay. Don't forget to do the same for the other side as well. We can easily mirror it since we haven't done any UV mapping, so I'm going to do that just to be consistent. Okay. And here I'm going to add another edge loop, and of course we're going to cut that over here, like so. Alright, and then we'll go ahead and continue to adjust. Make sure we're being consistent, so I don't want it to go too far in. Don't want to break that flow. Great. And I'm going to add two divisions for this one because it is a large fur card. Let's hide that so it will help with the readability. And of course, merge vertex. Okay, looks good. For the one underneath, this one we can get away with. It's a very, very simple solution. Let's just complete that end. And I'm not going to bother with the edges because, actually I might. Let's do it because it can be visible to some. But in terms of the averaging, the normal smoothing it, I don't think we'll need to because, like I said, people won't be able to see this one. Specifically this one. And for this, I will bring it down, and of course add another edge loop here. So let's go ahead and do that. Like so. Good. Same deal here. Although, like the top one, I'm not as worried about where this will go. So I will just leave it clipped in into that ear. Okay. But I do want to add a little bit of resolution. Remember, this part of the ear is going to animate. Sorry, it's going to rig and deform. So we need to have a little bit of resolution so that the polygon can follow it. Okay, delete that. Nice little point, looks good. Of course, we want to try and avoid clipping as much as we can, so I'm going to bring that down ever so slightly. Like so. Just a little bit of clipping, so I'll move it here. Maybe make it flow in this direction. You can add a little bit more if you want, depending on how anal you are about it. Alright, and then we'll go to our vertex. Put the point, basically delete it. I have no idea why I didn't do that in the first place. I guess that didn't register in my mind when I was working on it. Okay, and of course adjusting it. And as previous fur cards, this one won't be visible to the audience in general, so we're not going to bother matching it to the topology of the head. We'll just clip it into the skull, and that's basically it, okay? Okay, over here, same deal. Again, not as visible, so we can get away with a little bit of laziness. And of course, I'm going to add another edge right there. Oop, that's not what I wanted to do. Like so. Great. Okay, looking good so far. Really, really loving how this is turning out. Alright, for this one, I might actually delete that particular one, because this one will be fairly large. And just like the one on top, I'm going to match the topology primarily because people can see it. Okay, and we will again break our rule, and I'm going to split a polygon on the skull down in this direction. And what this will do is will allow us to have perfect deformations for this particular fur card. So we'll move it down, and I'm going to do double up again, because it is large. Let's give it some wiggle room, okay? A bit of resolution. And of course, we're going to go ahead and fix that. Let's delete the top here. Let's push them in. Good. Feel free to use the sculpt tool if you want as well. But because it's so low poly, so using the sculpt tool, like sculpt geometry, may not be a good thing, so it might give you some undesirable results. It's worth trying, just using the tools at hand to see what we get. That's okay, it's pretty good pointed feel. And you can use the soft select as well, so I'm going to do that. Check my silhouette. Just adjust the flow, and there we go. right, for this one, I'm going to have to adjust that particular for... Unfortunately, I forgot to push the bottom one in, so let's go ahead and do that. Remember, we're trying to clip this into our mesh so that we don't have any seams flying around. For this particular one, I can go ahead. Let's just move it up ever so slightly. Up till here. Like that. Like that. And like that. Okay. Add two divisions. And start tweaking. Alright, looking good. Sharpen that end. Let's go to our side view. Double check our flow, which is looking good. That's basically it. I just want to be careful of that clipping right there, so that's better. Alright, a few more. And we can, once again, give it two divisions. Double check the silhouette. And hoping you guys are enjoying this course so far. Of course, your experiences may vary depending on your skill level, how much you've learned, how quickly you can get this information into your mind. For some people, it might be one of the most frustrating things to do. And it could be a number of reasons. Maybe your motivation's just out. You probably can't be bothered doing it. That's okay. But hopefully the process is inspiring you enough to the point where you can go, I can do it. It's not as difficult as I first thought. So in a way, I'm hoping that sort of is kind of helping you guys. All right, so for these two, I'm going to do the same thing. Let's go ahead and add one division. And of course, merging the vertex here. Very tempting for you to be a bit careless when it comes to attention to detail sometimes, and I'm speaking this in context of you being a little bit more experienced, maybe later down the track. When you gain experience in this, as you learn, you'll find yourself getting a bit quicker over time. But as we all know, there is going to be a cap on how fast you can work, okay? Even with all the efficiency you have in the world, all the mail scripts, all this other automated stuff, you're going to get to a point where you can't get any faster, no matter what you do. So, but one thing doesn't change during the time, and that's one thing you can always still improve, and that would be attention to detail. You can always constantly push yourself to get better in the quality of your work rather than speed. So speed shouldn't necessarily be a focus for most of us. We just need to learn the principles and then begin tightening up our skills over time, okay? So looks like the back of the fur is looking really nice and organized. I'm pretty pleased with that. I'm gonna use this last one. And this one might be a bit tricky. I want it to be a bit fatter and smaller. And we're just seeing where we can put that. Another thing I also want to do is make sure I split the appropriate polygons on the other side as well, just in case I forget. Alright, and so we can maybe place this one over here. And this one might be a square instead. Okay, so that might help disguise just the base of that neck. It won't disguise all of it, just enough so that we can go, okay, cool, that's working. And I might give two divisions because I can make it a nice, smoother transition. Of course, we get rid of that. Get rid of that. Okay, looking good. I'm not worried about that one because we can add some more fur cards if you want. It's up to you. But for now, I'm looking at readability more than anything. Okay, so just double checking, it's looking good. All right, let's go combine all of these meshes together into one mesh, and then we'll go ahead and smooth those vertices out. All right, same deal as before. Oh, yes, and before we do, let's check our face normals. You can see some of them are reversed. That's not good. Let's go ahead and fix them up. So I'll select the ones that are facing the wrong direction, which at the moment I think it's basically all the planes. No idea how it got to that point. So I'll select the faces and then expand selection by pressing shift and period or full stop. And then we'll go to normals and reverse. There we go. Glad we got that. Got that specific step down. Alright. Now we can go ahead and just select the outside vertices of those fur cards. We might add more fur cards to go in between them. But for now, let's just get this one done. Done and dusted. Okay, there's another set in here, which I will select. Great. And of course we're going to deselect the other vertices here. So just checking, making sure it's running well, which it is. And of course we go to normals and average normals. Beautiful. Wireframe unshaded. It's looking good. Okay. So if we were to look at this character right now, we go, okay, cool, he's got nice hair on the back. That's done. Let's duplicate it, mirror it to the other side. Mirror duplicate. And when you mirror duplicate, remember that the other side still needs to be applied as well. We can do that later. For now, let's just make sure we have our hair looking readable, okay? That's it for this segment. Let's move on to the next part.